DuckStation is an amazing new PS1 emulator that's available for both PC and Android, and it was brought to my attention by a comment on one of my recent videos. So first of all, shout out to him for bringing this emulator to my attention. DuckStation is pretty new in the world of PlayStation 1 emulators, so today we're gonna dive into all the perks and features of DuckStation, such as graphics, APIs, and enhancements, how to set it up, and most importantly, how well it can run games, along with talking a little bit about the emulator itself and where it came from. I'm gonna talk mainly about the PC version in this video, but I'm probably going to make a video on DuckStation for Android sometime in the near future, so make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for that. Timestamps for each part of the video are on the screen, so let's get right into it, starting with a little bit about DuckStation itself. So DuckStation is being developed primarily by a person going by the name Stenzik. DuckStation is a very new emulator. I don't know exactly when DuckStation was started. There doesn't seem to be a lot of history on it that I can find, like some other emulators that I've researched, except that it's somewhat related to Dolphin Emulator, and apparently was used to test code for it in the past. But the oldest posts I can find on GitHub are from around November 2019, so I'm gonna guess that the emulator is maybe about a year and a half old, maybe a bit older. But the point is that this emulator has really been gaining a lot of traction in the last 6 months or so, as it's gotten better and better. There's a lot of great features built into it along with a great UI, so let's get right into how to install DuckStation on PC. PC installation is actually very easy. Just Google DuckStation and the GitHub page will come up as the first result. On the right-hand side of the screen, you're gonna see a section that says Releases. Click on Latest Development Build and you'll be taken to the most updated version of DuckStation. Scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page and you'll see the Assets section. For Windows, you wanna click on the one labeled DuckStation Windows X64 Release.zip and download it. Once you're done, make sure you allow it to get past your antivirus. Just move the file wherever you want to store DuckStation on your computer and unzip it, and you're almost done. Once downloaded and extracted, you can launch the emulator with DuckStation Qt X64 Release LTCG.exe. It's a mouthful, I know, but that's just the file you need to launch it. Next, you have to either drop your BIOS file into DuckStation's BIOS subdirectory that it has built in, which is located in a folder called DuckStation, which is going to be in your user's documents folder. Or if you don't want to save it there, you can direct DuckStation towards whatever BIOS directory you want through the settings. Finally, just add a directory for your games using the settings menu and you're all good to go. DuckStation is super easy to set up and it only takes a few minutes. So now that we have DuckStation installed, we're going to dive right into the myriad of great features that DuckStation has to offer. Right off the bat, you may notice that DuckStation has a really nice UI. And if you've ever used Dolphin Emulator for GameCube and Wii, it may look kind of familiar to you. That's because DuckStation, as I said earlier, was actually originally used as a testing ground for code for Dolphin, and the UI was actually pulled directly from Dolphin, which is actually pretty awesome if you ask me. It's really great. One thing you'll notice is that everything is labeled, super accessible, and easy to understand. It's so easy to use and do whatever you want with DuckStation, as it's very user-friendly. One of the best features that DuckStation provides is the utilization of the Vulkan Graphics API, which lets games run very, very efficiently through this emulator, more so than other APIs. Along with the various graphics enhancements like resolution scaling, anti-aliasing, and texture filtering, DuckStation also provides access to something called Precision Geometry Transform Pipeline, or PGXP. What PGXP does is it basically reduces the warping and wobbling effect that is common to PS1 games. On top of this, you can also use your own external shaders to further enhance the look of games, though this is a feature I haven't tried out yet. Overall, with all these enhancements, PS1 games look absolutely beautiful to me in this emulator. I've tried quite a few games, though I thought Crash Bandicoot 2 in particular looks absolutely amazing. Maybe not quite like the Insane Trilogy, but it looks way better than a standard PS1 game for sure. Honestly, every game I run through this emulator comes out looking amazing, and I couldn't imagine playing these games any other way, because this is just the best, period. But besides graphical enhancements, DuckStation also has a lot of other cool features too. Of course, it has the standard ones you'd expect, like controller support and mapping, along with save states and memory cards, but it also has a couple of nice added perks. For example, something this emulator does that not many others do is create a save state whenever you exit a game, so that when you start it up again, you resume at the exact spot where you left off. I mean, this isn't groundbreaking, of course, but it's something that I haven't seen many other emulators do, and it's honestly a nice little quality of life touch that makes things more convenient instead of having to either have to, you know, save the game or manually make and load a save state. Another nice convenience is the fact that DuckStation has a configurable auto updater, so you don't have to check GitHub every time there's a new release. Furthermore, you can enable Discord presence, and this makes it so that the game you're playing shows up in your Discord profile, which is just a nice little thing as well. One really cool feature is called Rewind, and basically it periodically makes a save state that you can roll back to in case you make a mistake, so you don't have to manually create and load save states. DuckStation even makes use of an optional achievement system as well, which is pretty cool. DuckStation just really does a great job by giving people a lot of options and convenience features and making them all easy to find and manage. I've only been using DuckStation for about a week, but in that time, I've encountered no problems, which is really quite impressive, especially for an emulator that isn't very old. Every game I've tried runs absolutely flawlessly. DuckStation is set up in a way so that pretty much every game should run smoothly on all the default settings, and very few tweaks are needed, if any, which is very much the opposite of most other emulators. Hacks are almost never needed, and there are a few enhancement options that could break some games, but you can easily just turn them off. DuckStation is designed so that right out of the box, games work amazingly, and I never thought that PS1 games with such low polygon counts could look so good. I definitely recommend giving DuckStation a try. It's really an amazing experience. That's gonna be all for today. Thanks for watching my video. If you liked it, make sure you like and subscribe for future content. Have a good one.